Please subscribe to our channel by pressing the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon and get all the latest video updates directly on your mobile phone. So hello friends, we will be discussing about the various population forecasting methods. Population forecasting is very important in civil engineering field because we use population forecasting to predict the future population of a particular city or a town or a village. Take for example the population of Bangalore. And Bangalore city's population in 2001 census was around 1 crore. So this was in 2001 census, according to 2001 census. In 2001 itself, they predicted the population of Bangalore city to be around 10 crores. So they predicted the population of Bangalore to be around 10 crores in 2050. So this type of prediction, the future prediction of a city's population is possible by using population forecasting methods. So here we will be looking at various population forecasting methods. Before starting, please subscribe to our channel Civil Engineer Buddy. And also please do visit our website www.civilengineerbuddy.com. And the first method we will be looking at is the arithmetic mean method, or is also called as arithmetic increase method. The second method is geometric mean method or geometric increase method. The third one is incremental increase method. The fourth one is decrease in growth rate method. The fifth one is logistic curve method. So let's start with arithmetic increase method. So dear friends, we will be looking at arithmetic increase method in this video. We will be solving problems. Let's start with arithmetic increase method. The formula for arithmetic increase method is Pn is equal to P0 plus Nx bar. If you remember this formula, it is sufficient. So here Pn is the population at nth decade. See, for example, I will give you a table, year, population. The question will be given for you like this. Say for example, in 1980, the population of a particular city is 40,000. In 1990, it is around 60,000. In 2000, it is 80,000. In 2010, it is 1 lakh. And they will be giving these data and they will be asking you to find the population of this particular city in 2030. Say for example, in 2030. Then there you go. The Pn is equal to P 2030. So Pn is nothing but the year in which they are, for which they ask the population of this particular city. So dear friends, P naught is nothing but the last given population of the last given decade. So here the last given decade is 2010, from after which the population is not given. Say 2020 population is not given, right? So the population, last decade of the population known is 2010. So the population at 2010, that is 1 lakh, will be our P naught. So P naught will be the last known decade's population, that is P naught. So we got to know Pn, I mean we will be finding Pn, but we got to know the meaning of Pn, we got to know the meaning of P naught, and we will be getting P naught value. And N, see how to find N. So it will be like N is equal to 2030, the population for which the for the decade asked, minus 2010, the last known decade population, I mean that decade is 2010, divided by 10. So it is like decade for which population is asked, minus last known decade, divided by 10. So like this we can find out N. So now N is over. X bar, I will give you an example problem and I will solve this. See, for example, they will give year and population. Say 1950, say around 1000, 1960, 10,000, 1970, 20,000, 1980, 30,000, 1990, 50,000. Okay, now we have to find out the population. If suppose they ask the population for 2020, so Pn will be P 2020, P P naught will be 50,000, the population at the last known decade. N will be 2020, they have asked for, and last known is 1990, divided by 10, which will give you, gives you 3. Therefore, N is equal to 3 X bar. We have to find out the X bar, right? So how will you find the X bar? What is X bar? Now I will tell you. You have to make another column here in the solution. Year, population, per decade, increase in population. See, what is the given data? 1950, 1960, 1970, 1980, 1990. Per decade increase in population, as the name itself suggests, the increase in population per one decade. What is the decade? Decade is a 10 year. So what is the increase in population for this decade? That is 1950 to 1960. The increase in population is 10,000 minus 1,000. That is 9,000. How? See, earlier in 1950, the population was 1,000. And later in 1960, the population is 10,000. So that means in one decade, so that is in 10 years, the population increased 9,000 numbers. From 1,000 to 10,000, 9,000 population has been increased. So this is per decade increase in population. Per one decade, what is the increase in population? That is this value. 20,000 minus 10,000, which gives you 10,000 again. 20,000 minus 10,000. Just subtract. 30,000 minus 20,000. 10,000 again. 50,000 minus 30,000. 20,000. That means from 1950 to 1960, 9,000 number of people have came to the city. From 1960 to 1970, 10,000 number of people have came to the city. From 1970 to 1980, 10,000 again, 10,000 number of people came. But from 1980 to 1990, more number. That is 20,000 people have came to the city. So this is the meaning of this per decade increase in population. I think you got it. If you have any doubt, please comment your doubts in the comment section, please. So how to find X bar? X bar is equal to, add up all this, divided by how many there? 1, 2, 3, 4. We are taking average. Just we are taking the average number of increase in population. So that is 12,250. So X bar is equal to 12,250. That means in general, we can say for every one decade, 12,250 increase in population have taken place. That is, it's just like saying for every one decade, on an average, 12,250 number of people have came to the city. So that is X bar. So what was needed for the formula? Pn, that is P2020, they have asked for population, is equal to P naught plus Nx bar is the formula, right? So P2020 is equal to P naught. What is P naught? 50,000 population at the last known decade plus N. N is 3. Here we have found out N is equal to 3. Into X bar, we have found it out to be 12,250. So we have found out the population at 2020 for the city whose population has been increasing in this order in this particular years. So that population for 2020, it came to be around 86,750. This method is called as arithmetical increase method. So you now saw that how to find out the population for a particular city using arithmetic increase method. Now, why we are using various other methods? We can use this method itself now. Why we are using other methods? Because this method, that is the arithmetic increase method, has some drawbacks. So we will be looking at various drawbacks of arithmetic increase method. So the first drawback is lowest value. These things are very important for gate examination. The main drawback of arithmetic increase method is lowest value. That is, this method gives the lowest value of the population. See, if we use other methods like the geometric increase method or any other method, as you will be seeing in the future videos, the population comes to be very much higher than this value, higher than 86,750. So the main drawback of arithmetic increase method is it gives the lowest value of population. For example, if you use the same method to find out the population of Bangalore, it will give a lowest estimate. But at that time in the future, the real population might be very much higher. So this is the major drawback. The second one is it is mainly used for old cities. Settled cities. As I said earlier, the other methods of population forecasting is geometric increase method, incremental increase method, decreasing growth rate method, and logistic curve methods. We will be looking at these methods in the upcoming videos. So thanks for watching the video. If you have not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel. So please do visit our webpage www.civilengineerbuddy.com, and please do subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching the video.